Hallelujah, it's another time of mercy and favor challenge. It's an amazing day, and there's no better way to start our day except in the presence of God, praying to God. Our Father is prayer answering God, and today we will be an exception because we'll be hearing and answering our prayers. Our prayer focus for today is prayers for divine instruction. It's an amazing day, and we are starting off our prayers with thanksgiving like we normally do. We are thanking God for all His goodness, for His mercies, and for everything He has done. Our day is marvelous because God is marvelous. The Bible says in the book of Psalm 89 and verse 1, "Forever and ever I will sing about the tender kindness of the Lord, young and old hear about your blessings." Let's go ahead and give thanks to God for His tender mercies. Go ahead and acknowledge that God has been tender to you. He has shown you tender mercies. Go ahead, give Him thanks for the next 4 minutes.
El brazo de la banda,
In this segment, we are praying for our nation and our church. Right here, I'm praying for Nigeria and I'm praying for my local assembly, Shouts of Praise Center. The Bible says in the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 7, and verse 14, it says, "If my people who are called by my name humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and forgive their sins and heal their land." Go ahead, intercede, pray to God. Turn from your wicked ways and ask that God should hear our cry.
Thank you.
Here we are praying for our pastors, our parents, and our mentors. Join me because I am praying for my pastors, I'm praying for my parents, and I'm lifting up my mentors before God. You go ahead, you can mention your parents, your pastors, and your mentors. And our scripture is in 1 Peter chapter 5 and verse 9, verse 4, sorry. And when the great shepherd appears, you will receive a crown of unending glory and honor. Lift up your voice and pray that your parents, pastors, and mentors will receive a crown of unending glory and honor.
El
In this segment, we are praying together for our finances. We are lifting up our finances before the throne of grace. We are receiving grace. We are receiving insight. We are receiving wisdom to handle our finances. The Bible says in the book of 2 Chronicles chapter 9 and verse 8, God is able to make it up to you by giving you everything you need. And also, there will not be enough for your own needs, but plenty left over to give joyfully. Lift up your heart before God. Cry unto Him.
Shalom,
Right now, we are praying for the next 4 minutes for our family. We are together lifting up our family members before God, and that God will give us our members of our families, our husband, our wives, our children. And if you are not engaged, you are praying also for that person who are going to marry. The Bible says in the book of Genesis, chapter 29, verse 21, the Amplified Version, finally Jacob said to Laban, "Give me my wife, for my time is completed, so that I may take her to me. Go ahead, lift up your voice, intercede. Go ahead."
Thank you. Sembrando
In this segment of prayer, we are doing warfare, and our prayer point is simple. We are asking, according to 1 Timothy chapter 4 and verse 1, now the Spirit speaketh expressly. You will be praying, you will be making warfare, you will be lifting up your voice to God, and you will be asking that the Spirit of God should speak to you. The Spirit of God should speak to you in the way that you will hear in the name of Jesus. You will go ahead and begin to pray for divine instruction. Ask God to speak to you concerning your family, concerning ministry, concerning your children, concerning every aspect.
Shalom,
In this segment of prayer, you are lifting your desire to the Lord. That you are praying according to Isaiah chapter 30 and verse 21. Your own ear will hear it. Right behind you, a voice will say, this is the way you should go, whether to the right or to the left. You will go ahead using this scripture. You will pray that you will always hear divine instruction, that you will hear a voice behind you. Oh, Marakotia Kalabababa. You will be led by the Spirit of God. Oh, Marakataya Baba. Go ahead, pray this prayer.
Everybody,
In Jesus' name, in this segment of prayer, we are praying and we are declaring Psalm 91. You will go ahead and recite the whole of Psalm 91 from the beginning to the end. Now, our prayer focus is in verse 5 of Psalm 91. It says that thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor the arrow that flies by day. Go ahead, cover every member of the family, your loved ones, cover them with this scripture. Begin to pray that the protection of the Lord is upon them in the name of Jesus.
Embrando
In this segment, you are declaring what the blood of Jesus has done. You are doing the blood declaration. In the book of Matthew, chapter 26 and verse 28, the TLB translation, it says, "For this is my blood, sealing the new covenant. It is poured out to forgive the sins of multitude." We will begin to pray. And that by the blood of Jesus that was shed for you, it has removed every form of sin in your life. Therefore, the devil does not have anything to hold on you.
Everybody, Entrando Shalaka,
Here we are praying the polite prayers. We are asking God for wisdom. In Amosia, the Bible says in the book of Ephesians, chapter 1 and verse 17, I pray that God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, might give you spiritual wisdom and revelation in your growing knowledge of Him. Oh, go ahead and pray this prayer. You will ask God for spiritual wisdom and understanding in everything you do. Intercede with the whole of your heart. Pray for the next 4 minutes and I'll be back to join us. Everybody, Whether you are sick in your body or it is members of your family, your loved ones, or you know a particular person that has been sick for a while, here is the word of God in the book of John chapter 5 and verse 4. It says, for an angel of the Lord came from time to time to disturb the water, and the first person to step down into it afterward was healed. Hear me. There is no angel that is troubling the water. What we have to do right now is to trouble the Spirit of God within us by praying in tongues. Go ahead and intercede for healing.
Shut up,
Yeah, we are praying for the favor and the mercy of God. The favor and the mercy of God is real. It's a tangible force and we have to pray for it. The Bible says in the book of Genesis chapter 39 and verse 21, it says, "But the Lord was with Joseph and showed him mercy, and gave him favor in the sight of the keeper of the prison." You are going to cry unto God. You are going to ask that the Lord will show you his mercy. Oh, Marakataya Baba, Ela Baba Baba. And therefore, he will give you his goodness favor in the name of Jesus
Christ. Embrando Embrando Sando Shabaka,
Go ahead, begin to rejoice and give thanks to God because our prayers are answered. Go ahead, lift up your hands, lift up your voice, and begin to give thanks to the Lord because our God is a prayer answering God. Hallelujah, glory to God. Let me make some prophetic declarations into our lives today. In the mighty name of Jesus, God will show you mercy. Name of Jesus, he will show you mercy and give you that needed favor to move you forward, to cause you to prosper in the name.